Nowhere is the genius of Sony video technology more clearly evident than in the new Betamax SL-2500. Just look at it. Its ultra-sophisticated styling will complement even the most advanced high-fidelity components. But the genius doesn't stop with the styling. This new Betamax is equipped with more new features than ever before. In fact, you may find many new features never before available in home video recorders. To start with, the SL-2500 is unbelievably compact, with a front panel that measures only 17 inches wide and 3 1/8 inches tall. The SL-2500 is roughly half the size of most competing video recorders. To achieve this miniaturization, Sony reduced the dimensions of all key internal components, like the head drum assembly, which was reduced to half the height with the development of new flat motors. The capstan and reel tables also utilize these flat motors, also contributing to the extreme low profile of the SL-2500. In features and functions, the SL-2500 is clearly out in front of the rest. The SL-2500 is completely front-operated, front-loading. That's right, front-loading. Just insert your Betamax tape into the front cassette compartment door, and your tape is gently loaded into the machine. Sony's also made some improvements to the U-loading system. By moving some of the components, Sony was able to reduce the space required for tape transport while retaining all the benefits of U-loading. Benefits like lower tape tension and greater tape interchangeability. With all command controls located up front, operation is easier than ever. These feather touch function buttons offer full logic microprocessor control, which means you don't have to press stop between modes. LED indicators let you know at a glance which operating mode you're in, an important feature in front-loading machines where tape movement is not visible. The SL-2500 automatically senses and selects the correct playback speed, Beta 1, Beta 2, or Beta 3. These three LEDs indicate the beta speed of your tape. To give a quick reference of your position on any tape, Sony has equipped the SL-2500 with the unique six-step LED tape remaining indicator. This divides any tape, no matter what the length, into six equal time segments. When a fully rewound tape is loaded for recording or playback, the LEDs will blink on and off as soon as tape movement begins. The six LEDs fully lit indicate that you are at the beginning of the tape. As the tape advances, the LEDs go out one by one. When you get to the last 5 minutes of the tape, the last LED begins to blink on and off to tell you that you're nearing the end of your tape. Swing search, another ingenious idea, gives you pinpoint accuracy at 5 playback speeds in both forward and reverse. Not only that, the SL-2500 gives you crystal clear reproduction with no picture noise in any slow or freeze frame modes. This kind of slow motion ability is usually found only on professional videotape recorders. The fluorescent digital display panel serves three important functions. First, it is a very accurate quartz clock, displaying the correct day and time. Second, the display guides you through the simple conversational style setting procedure for the 4-event, 2-week timer. Finally, it displays Sony's linear time counter. This very accurate tape timer counts control track pulses in both forward and reverse directions, giving a precise readout of elapsed recording or playback time in hours, minutes, and seconds. Here's another Sony exclusive, tab marker indexing. This new electronic indexing system allows you to index your tapes into 9 segments for random access to any pre-selected point at a push of a button. If you want to choose new index points later, the index pulses can be recorded and erased as many times as you want. Removing any unwanted material requires editing. With Sony's micro timing phase, or TP circuitry, the SL-2500 brings professional backspace editing to the world of home video. This means no more glitches or noise bars, which usually accompany pause edits. As you can see, the SL-2500 clearly offers a new dimension in recording and playback control. And to make that control complete, the SL-2500 comes supplied with our most advanced multifunction controller, the RMT-312 Remote Commander. The RMT-312 is an infrared wireless remote control. That's right, wireless. You have easy control of every key function, including channel change. Take some time now to experience the new Betamax SL-2500. Once you do, you'll know there's only one company that could have done it. Sony, the one and only. Despite all its features and functions, operating the SL-2500 is simplicity itself. That's where Sony's human engineering comes into the picture. Like these new full-logic microprocessor-controlled functions, you simply press the button for the function you want. No need to stop the tape first. Betamax makes it foolproof. But let's start at the beginning. It all starts by pushing the power switch located on the upper left-hand side. Insert the tape to be played back into the front-loading cassette compartment. The tape is gently pulled into the unit, seated, and the tape is loaded around the drum. The cassette door clearly indicates whether a tape is loaded or not. Press the play button, and your picture will appear immediately. The SL-2500 automatically senses and selects the beta mode at which your tape was recorded, and indicates the playback speed with an LED indicator. The SL-2500 has audio and video outputs for direct connection to Sony's new ProField monitor system, or any television or video projection system equipped with audio and video inputs. An antenna output, which is switch selectable for channel 3 or 4, is provided for conventional television sets. If tracking error occurs, this is a noticeable noise in the picture, use the tracking controls located on the secondary operating panel for normal, fast play, and slow motion modes. To visually search at high speed for a desired segment of any tape, use beta scan. If your tape was recorded in beta 2, the high speed search is 9 times normal play in both forward and reverse directions. In beta 3, the search speed is 15 times normal. To initiate beta scan, just press the fast forward or rewind button while the unit is in the play mode. To return to play, simply release the button. Betascan allows you to search hours of recordings, stopping to view only what interests you. That's fast, but that's not all. By pressing the swing search button, a new feature, then the times 2 button, and forward, the SL-2500 will scan your tape at twice normal speed in the forward direction. Now reduce to normal speed. Then 1/5 normal speed, and still slower to 1/10 normal speed. That's real slow motion, but wait. By pressing the step button, your picture will advance 1 frame at a time. And finally, press freeze. Your tape is perfectly still with a crystal clear picture displayed. Again, if for some reason a noise bar should appear while in swing search speeds below normal, adjust the tracking control for slow motion located on the secondary panel. These crystal clear pictures are the result of Sony's exclusive double azimuth head system. In the original azimuth recording, each video head was slanted 7 degrees off center to eliminate crosstalk from overlapping adjacent video tracks. When a videotape is still framed, both video heads track the same video path. But one head has an azimuth that corresponds to the tracks on either side of the one we're scanning. This introduces jitter and noise. The solution involved giving the second head a double azimuth. The second head's azimuth is selected depending on which mode the SL-2500 is in. In slow motion, both heads pick up the track we are scanning and ignore the interfering tracks on either side. Sony's double azimuth head system allows the two video heads to track one single video track to produce an image which is completely still and free of jitter or noise. After you've enjoyed the show, simply press the eject button. Here again, you need not stop the tape first. From any mode, the SL-2500 will automatically stop and then eject the tape. Before attempting to record on a Betamax cassette, check that the breakout safety tab has not been removed. If it is missing, place a piece of plastic tape over the hole. Insert your tape into the cassette window. To record TV programs off the air, use an RF cable between the SL-2500 and the Pro Field Tuner. Be sure to select the correct channel on your set. Insert a cassette. Press the program select button so that the lamp beside it lights up. Place the input select switch in the tuner position. Select the appropriate recording speed. Select the desired television channel to be recorded. Press record, then play. You're now recording. To view one program while recording another, press the program select button so that the indicator is out. Then select the desired viewing channel on your television set. To check your recording while in progress, select the channel your VCR plays back on and press the program select switch. To record from another video source, such as the portable Betamax SL-2000, connect video and audio to the respective connectors. Set the input select switch to the line PCM position. Select the recording speed, Beta 2 or Beta 3. Press the record and play buttons. The SL-2500 begins recording. You may edit recordings by pressing the pause button. Sony's new backspace editing feature allows for a no-noise, no-glitch edit, which is explained in the section on editing later in this tape. Press stop to end the recording. To connect a Sony Trinicon camera, align the K-type camera plug with a connector on the rear panel of the SL-2500. Set the input select switch to camera and make all necessary adjustments according to the camera's instruction manual. Press record, then play. The recorder is now in record pause. To begin recording, press the start-stop button on the camera. To momentarily stop the recording, press the start-stop button on the camera or the pause button on the recorder. To restart, press the same button. To protect the video heads and tape, the recorder will automatically release pause after about 8 minutes, returning the SL-2500 to the record mode. The SL-2500 is equipped with Sony's record review function for use with the Trinicon HVC-2200 color camera. By pressing one button on the camera hand grip, the recorder will automatically review the last 2 seconds of recorded tape in the viewfinder and pause in readiness for the next shot. The SL-2500 will make smooth, glitch-free edits. After the correct connections have been made, play back the recorder using swing search modes to find the point you wish to add on to. Then press pause, then record. Set the playback or source video tape recorder to the point where the video you wish to add begins. Press pause. To edit, release both pause buttons at the same time. When you pass the point at which you wish the edit to end, press pause on the recorder. To review your edit, put the SL-2500 in reverse beta scan until you see the edit point go by. Then let the recorder play back. Another smooth edit. How is this accomplished? When the recorder enters the record pause mode, the SL-2500 will back the tape up about 1/2 second and then pause. When the pause mode is released, the SL-2500 runs in playback until the video on the tape is synchronized with the video to be recorded next. The SL-2500 then enters the record mode. Sony's new TP circuitry gives you professional editing on home video recorders. You can add a completely new soundtrack or commentary to previously recorded tapes with Sony's audio dubbing function. This allows you to add a new soundtrack, erasing only the old sound portion of your tape. To record using a microphone, place the input select switch to the camera position. Connect a microphone into the mic in connector. Place the SL-2500 in play to find the point where you wish your new audio to begin. Press pause. Then audio dub. When you release the pause mode, the recorder will begin recording audio only. You can also dub sound from a tape recorder or stereo amplifier by connecting it to the audio in jack on the rear panel and placing the input select switch in the line PCM position. The RMT-312 remote commander will allow you to control every function on the SL-2500 wherever you're sitting, up to 25 feet away and more than 45 degrees on either side. The remote control uses infrared light to transmit your commands to the remote control detector located here, so there is no cumbersome wire to contend with. To install the batteries, first turn the unit over. Press down and away from the unit to remove the battery cover. Insert two AA size batteries, being careful to observe the correct polarity. Then slide the cover firmly back into place. Battery life under normal usage will be about 6 months. If the range of the unit becomes noticeably shorter, this is an indication of weak batteries. When the batteries become exhausted, the output indicator, located here, will not light when buttons on the unit are pressed. If you're not going to use the RMT-312 for a long period of time, remove the batteries to prevent possible damage due to battery leakage. The power switch will turn the recorder on and off. Press it once to turn it off. Press again to turn it on. These two buttons select the channel to be recorded or viewed. Press the right button to select up to the next higher channel. Press the left button to select down to the next lower channel. The remote program select button functions as on the recorder. This function allows the operator to view the playback of the VTR when the VTR light is on. Press this button once, the light goes out, and the tuner output can be monitored. This area houses the tape transport function controls. This cover allows you to protect the record buttons. This button is a safety button. It must be pressed at the same time as the record button to start recording. Thus, pressing the record button by itself will not result in accidental recording. This button is used to start normal VTR playback. The fast forward button will advance the tape rapidly forward. In playback, this button will enable beta scan forward. The rewind button enables the same operations in the reverse direction. This button will place the VTR in the stop mode, while this one places the VTR in pause. To select swing search, press this button once. Then select either frame by frame, step mode, 1/10 normal speed, 1/5 normal speed, or twice normal speed. Then select either forward, reverse, or freeze frame. In frame by frame playback, press and release the forward or reverse button once per frame. For continuous frame by frame playback, hold the button down. Express tuning allows you to select one of 14 preset television channels. Just press any of the 14 channel buttons and your choice is electronically selected. You can match any channel to any of the push buttons. Setting the channel selection button is simple. Located on the top upper right-hand side of the SL-2500 is the tuning compartment. Inside, you will find all the controls necessary for pre-setting the channels to all active stations in your area. Select the button you wish to preset. Turn the channel set switch to on. Turn the automatic fine tuning switch to off. Press the channel clear button to erase the previously assigned channel. The band indicating lamps indicate which band you are in, VHF low, VHF high, or UHF. The channel position indicator indicates the approximate position of the tuned channel within the tuning band scanned. All that is left is to tune in the channel desired. The minus button moves to a lower channel, while the plus button moves to a higher channel. When your selection is complete, return the AFT switch to on and the channel set switch to off. The channel set switch will automatically be switched off when the compartment is closed. Your preset channel is stored in a non-volatile memory IC and will not forget its setting even if the unit is unplugged or the power fails. The timer on the SL-2500 will allow you to record up to 4 programs at different times and on different channels at any time within a 2-week period. Sony makes it easy with a new conversational style setting procedure which prompts you through every step. Before we set the timer, let's check a few important items. Is the clock set to the correct day and time? Is a cassette of sufficient length to record your program inserted in the recorder? Is the record mode selector set to the tape speed you want? Is the input select switch set to the tuner position? On the secondary operating panel, press the timer set button once. The timer display will appear. Notice the letter flashing in the lower left-hand side of the display. The timer is asking you to select program A, B, C, or D. Press the plus button to go up and the minus button to go down. When you have chosen the program you want to set, press the next button. The days of the week will now blink. To record a program at the same time every day, press next. To select a specific day, press the plus button until the desired day is reached. You can even set a day in the second week. Incidentally, the second week we're talking about doesn't necessarily start with Monday. The second week always starts 7 days from today. When your day is set, press next. Now the timer is asking for the turn on time, hours first. Here again, press the plus button to advance, the minus button to go back. Then press next. Next, we set the turn on minutes. Then press next. We'll repeat the process for the turn off time. A turn-off time may be selected within 24 hours of the turn-on time. Turn-off hours will be set first. Then press Next. Now, turn-off minutes are set. Then press Next. We're now being asked to select the channel. Incidentally, the channel buttons will not change the channel during timer setting. Channel selection is made with the plus or minus buttons only. With this last step completed, press Next. The correct time and day should appear, showing that one program set cycle is completed. To set the timer record function, press the timer record button. This LED will light to indicate that the unit is standing by and will start recording and turn off at the preset times. To check your timer settings, press the timer check button. Each time you press the button, the display will step through the programs as follows. Program A, turn on time and day. Then program A, turn off time. Then program B, turn on time, and so on. The indicator of the pre-selected record channel will also blink. If the error lamp flashes while setting the timer, it means that the settings for the programs overlap. It is possible for timer recordings to be made with the error light on. To avoid undesirable results, check your programs for correct times. If the error lamp flashes but the timer standby lamp will not light, check the following. Is there a cassette in the recorder? Is the safety tab in place? Is the tape at its end? After correcting any of these problems, press the next button, then the timer record button. We've already covered the visual methods for locating desired tape segments like beta scan and swing search. Sony also provides several non-visual locating features that save you time and add to your playback control. The linear time counter is an example. By placing the counter clock switch in the counter position, you get a precise readout of elapsed time recording or playback time in hours, minutes, and seconds. Press the reset button to return the counter to its zero setting. This is convenient when you want to jump ahead 30 minutes or an hour into a recorded tape. It also gives you precise information for logging your tapes accurately. When you rewind past the zero point, the counter will display a minus sign to the left of the display. This counter works by counting control track pulses during playback, fast forward, and rewind. Since the CTL pulses are recorded on each tape as recordings are made, the counter will not operate with blank tapes. To return to the zero point, press stop, then return. The SL-2500 will automatically rewind or fast forward to the zero point. As you can see, this small package is really big on features. We invite you to witness a new generation of home video recorders. Sophistication in style, state-of-the-art in function, simplicity in operation. The new Betamax SL-2500. It clearly demonstrates the genius at Sony, the one and only.